Today we'll take a look at Inside Synthetics package and explore some synthetic seismograms. Well synthetics are a useful tool for relating seismic reflections to their corresponding layers and formations in wells. To open the synthetics view, go to the View menu and pick Synthetics. At this stage, nothing has been configured, so no information is presented in the window. Let's fix that. First, pick the well in the current well box at the top of the window. We're interested in well 11. Now to extract the trace along well 11's well path. In the Synthetic tab, click the plus button to create a synthetic test case. Multiple rows can be added, and each can contain a different synthetic case and seismic volume. We'll usually have one entry in here for each angle and stack combination to compare. For this introduction, we'll be comparing a simple zero offset or zero angle synthetic to a near stack volume. We'll use the default name near, an angle of 0 degrees, our wavelet, and a near stack seismic. We could add extra rows to explore the impact of different wavelets, but we'll stick to this single test for now. Once things are configured, a trace is extracted along the wellbore and displayed in the near track. Wavelets are managed in the Wavelet tab of the control panel. Here's one I created earlier. Wavelet parameters such as phase and amplitude are adjustable, and the wavelet updates on the fly. Wavelets default to an amplitude of 1, so you'll probably need to scale your wavelet to match your seismic amplitudes. A quick rule of thumb is to set the scale to 10 times the amplitude of your seismic, in this case 300,000. Now we'll configure our well. To calculate a zero offset synthetic, both compressional sonic and density logs are required. Shear sonic logs are also required for calculating synthetics at angles above 0 degrees. Let's select those curves now. Curves are filtered according to their class. If sections of the shear or density curves are missing, you can use a formula to infill the missing values. Make sure you understand these relationships before using them in your calculations. With poor quality or unprocessed logs, it is often useful to filter the raw log curves to seismic bandwidth. By checking this box, Insight will apply a sequential Backus average to the well curves before calculating the reflectivity. So where are our logs? We need to turn on the tracks in the View tab. Let's turn on the P impedance, VP, and density tracks. There's a lot going on here, so let's take a moment to explore this window. We've already seen the configuration tabs on the left. Almost all of the synthetics configuration is done in this area. The rest of the window is broken down into a series of tracks. Each track provides a display for curves of a particular type. Note that some tracks can be hidden, or are only available if their inputs have been configured. This track is for well navigation. The green highlight shows the section of the well displayed in the remainder of the window. We can move it, grab the edges to make adjustments to the view, or right-click and set the range. In this track, the mouse wheel adjusts the position, but in the other tracks, the mouse wheel adjusts the zoom level. The top and base of the default display window for all wells is set here, using either a constant or a horizon. You can control the calculation window separately by setting the window of interest here. Individual wells can override these settings with their own windows configured in the Well tab. The second track is an extra nav track. Any single curve from the well can be displayed here, but most users display the gamma ray log. The track width is easily changed here. These options apply to all the tracks. The third track is the P impedance track. This displays the acoustic impedance calculated from the sonic and density well logs. And speaking of which, the next two tracks show the density and velocity curves. The curves can be viewed as lines or infilled with colours to represent the data. The VP track can show more than just the sonic log. Right now, we can see three different curves. Let's turn them all off and look at them one by one. The dark blue curve is the interval of velocity calculated from the active set of time depth pairs at the well. The grey curve is the p-velocity calculated from the sonic log. The yellow curve is the velocity extracted from the velocity model configured for time depth conversion. Say we wanted to add a legend so at a glance we could see which curve was which. Right-click on the track view and select Configure Track. You can do a lot of configuration here. For example, edit the axis values or change the color of the curves. The time depth track gives a visual representation of the current time depth pairs for the well. Time depth pairs are shown in blue, but if they're grey, check you have ownership of the time depth set, not just the well. The next track displays your synthetic, an extracted seismic trace. One track is created for each synthetic test that we configured earlier. The red curve is a synthetic, and the blue is the stack trace extracted from the volume. You can toggle the display of each curve individually here. Now, how closely does our synthetic and seismic trace match? The correlation track shows the correlation coefficient calculated over a sliding window from the synthetic and the seismic trace, so we know what each track represents. Let's add some useful annotations. Let's turn on the cursor values. Moving the cursor over the track views shows the values at the cursor point along the bottom. We can check where key horizons or markers intersect our synthetic by turning them on. You may be thinking, where are the time depth pairs populated from? How do I add or remove them? Time depth pairs are loaded from the active set in the well configuration, and any changes you make in the synthetics view automatically update that set. Be careful you're working with the right set of TD pairs. A good approach is to make a copy before you get started. It's easy to make a copy. Set it as a default set, and then view them. Each line is a single time depth pair. Click and drag to adjust the two-way time value. The depth will stay constant, and the time will be updated. Note the interval velocity curve and the synthetics update on the fly, reflecting the new changes. To grab multiple pairs, hold Shift and select the TD pairs, then drag. Precise adjustments can be made by shift-selecting pairs, then using the up and down arrows at the base of the track. Each click of the arrow shifts the points by the increment here. Create a new time depth pair by right-clicking in the track. A manual time depth pair can also be created here. To apply a specific bulk shift, right-click and select all. Then use the arrows at the base of the track or simply drag all the time depth pairs. To clear the selection, right-click and select Clear All. Our synthetic tile looks pretty good for this one trace. How do we view our synthetic against multiple adjacent traces? We can view our synthetic generated curves against the seismic in section view. To ensure the synthetic generated curves are available outside the synthetics window, we need to tick the Add Output Curves to Wells options in the Synthetics tab. Along with the synthetic seismic, the synthetics tool calculates several new log curves for us, such as p-velocity and p-impedance. The log curve will have the prefix synth, so in this case it will be called synth near. The synthetic can now be displayed like any log curve in InSight. The synthetic will now appear as a log curve in the well. So let's see this in the inline crossline view. Where is our log curve? The default curve displayed is density, not wiggle. So we are seeing the density display of the synthetic. Density can be turned off and wiggle turned on in default well settings. That's better. Remember that the amplitude of your synthetic is dependent on the amplitude of your wavelet. If your amplitudes don't match your seismic, check that the wavelet amplitude scale is appropriate for your data. InSight updates everything on the fly. So if you want to edit your synthetic, try displaying the synthetic view alongside the inline crossline view. Any edits will be automatically updated. If you have questions or would like to discover more, then visit our website at www.dog.com. And remember, have fun with InSight!